Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today I'm going to tell you a trick that will make your printhead last three times longer. If you stay at the end of the video, I'll tell you how to make it last longer than a Toyota. If you have a car, when you do the oil change, do you also rotate your tire? If you don't, just skip this video, it's not for you. In 2003, I made a mistake, bought a Toyota Corolla. I drove this car for 10 years. Once I really drove it. Every weekend I drove from Michigan State University where I work to see my wife at the University of Illinois. So three states, one weekend, every weekend. After 8 years, I decided to kill this car and buy another car. So I stopped oil change. I drove it for 2.5 more years and the car didn't have any new oil. It still runs like a champ. I also tried so many things to kill it. Eventually, I just gave up and gave it to a friend as a gift. My point is, most of people treat their printhead like a Toyota Corolla. If we tilt the printhead towards light, we're going to see six columns of nozzles. Each column is a color. The middle two are whites, and I know I'm holding the printhead upside down and the order should be reversed. The yellow should be on the right and the cyan should be on the left. However, just to simplify it, have you noticed how your printer print DTF films? It'll print the color first, then it coat it with white. So how the printer do this? The answer is the printer divide each column into two rows. So when you print the color and the white, your RIP software is going to print the color on the top row, and your whites are printed on the bottom row. So you can see the top of the whites never get used, and the bottom of the color nozzles never get used. You're using 1/3 of your printhead all the time. Okay, here's my interpretation of a nozzle. This nozzle clogged by the white ink. Actually, your nozzle doesn't clog like that. It clogged like this. The white ink is going to build up around the pipe. Because the white ink is a high viscosity ink, so the things get worse and worse, then you get blocked. However, if you give a break, you just run regular distilled water or regular ink, and that's going to wash those white out and reverse the process. So let's say we've been printing with this color sequence for a while, and the white is not clogged yet, but it start build up. Now we can rotate the color. We move two whites to the left. You notice all the nozzles hasn't been used before. Now it's printing. You print brand new nozzles. I've seen people crying on the Facebook group. They print a nozzle check, say, oh, I got a dialing tomorrow, now my white clogged. And I always reply, oh, I rotated your color. So now you understand what I mean, you treat your printhead like a Corolla. Let me show you how to do it. Here, my two whites are in the middle, just like yours. By the way, I modified this printer, so when it's not printing, I take the white damper out and put in two dampers with distilled water in it. Today, I'm going to just show you with a distilled water damper. Here, I just take the yellow and the black damper out, move them to the middle. I take two distilled water damper, or white damper, and put on the left. To help the printer a little bit, I just use a syringe to suck air from the waste tube. I park the printhead at the capping station and draw from the waste tube slowly and make sure I feel some resistance. I just suck a little bit. That especially help the white ink get into the nozzles because you're changing the low viscosity ink with high viscosity ink. So that's why sometimes your color works but your white will not get in. Another tool you can use is this priming clip, and there is instruction on the page show you how to use it. The advantage is you can select the color each time you select two columns to prime. For example, we don't have to disturb the magenta and the cyan for this swap. Then after prime it, I usually run a mild cleaning, either a light cleaning or medium cleaning. So I just go to the RIP software and I send a cleaning command. The one in the RIP software is really mild. It won't damage the printer. I do not do strong cleaning, I do not do purge. Now we have to tell the computer we've done. So in your RIP software, so we click a color and go set up. We change from YKWW to WW, a yellow, black. Make sure to click save before clicking OK. The printhead is already primed, so we can just go print. Pay attention to where the color starts. The color pretty much starts just off the roller. The white ink starts about here. There's a little bit of water cover the M, but however, there's not a lot, so something wrong with my white ink or distilled water ink. But you can see the yellow and the black, they come out nicely. So if I just keep printing, the yellow and the black is going to clean the old white channels, the two channels in the middle. Then when I check the distilled water and I found out I accidentally pulled the tubes out of the tank, so there's no water in there. So now you know the trick that you can use all three channels on the bottom for white. However, you might wonder, when my white clog, the whole column of white clogs, I never use the nozzle on the top for white. Why those nozzle clog? However, if you think about it, your printhead is cleaned and filled with white ink, and only white ink come out from the bottom. The top row, there's no ink coming out. You're just waving the printhead around in the air when you do the printing. No ink coming from the top. So the top is more likely to clog than the bottom, right? So when you find the bottom clogged, the top is clogged as well. So how can I manage the top of the whites? One thing is do intermediate cleaning during the printing. The second one is try once a while in your job during the day, try to print the whole column white. Here we get a white image and we turn off color and white. We see the color be copy be zero, white copy be one print. You probably cannot see it, but the clear water come out right away. That means you're using the top of the nozzles. Similarly, I print a small strip of color and I turn off the white. I uncheck the color and the white. Then I say white copy be zero and the color copy be one. Now the color columns, they're using the whole column for color that clean up the bottom row nozzles. You can see at the starting of the water, there's still some leftover black from the previous ink channel. After you do the daily maintenance, which I have another video for it, and also do the color rotation, your printhead almost never clog. And eventually you're going to run into a problem which the printhead just weird out. You're going to have a dead pixel. Let's say I have two dead pixels here and there. There are two of them. I made a red cross. When you push the ink in, you're going to see it's not clogged, but it just hit that pixel, the film get the word out. So there's no way you can fix it. Then instead of moving them, two of them together, now you can think like maybe spread your whites. For example, for the yellow channel right now, you can put a white there because the white will never use that pixel. Here I just show you how many times I move those dampers around. So you can see I really beat the shit off the printhead. Okay, I just add more water to the maintenance tank and put a tube in. My white only stays in the printhead for a couple hours during the printing, then get all cleaned out by the water. I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at bch.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers!